Hi, you are watching VSDC channel, and today we're talking about subtitles. Subtitles are an easy way to make your videos more accessible, especially if you are publishing them for a wide audience on social media. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to add subtitles to your videos in VSDC and explain how to use markers for synchronizing subtitles with narration. Let's get started. Once you've added your footage to the scene, it's time to add subtitles. There are two options you can use, depending on whether you have a pre-made subtitle file or not. If you do, your file must be in SRT format for the program to recognize its content. You can create SRT files using the Notepad text editor or dedicated freeware such as Open Subtitle Editor. To upload the transcript, hit the CC button on the left-hand side and follow the prompts. Select the place for the subtitles on the scene, and once you do that, the file will instantly appear on the timeline, and the subtitles will start displaying. If you don't have the file ready, you can create subtitles right in the program. Just hit the CC button on the left, select Cancel when the program suggests uploading the file, and hit OK in the Object Position Settings window. Then select the place for the subtitles on the scene and hit Edit Subtitles. From there, you'll need to manually add subtitles, phrase by phrase, using the following format. The first line indicates the subtitle order number. The second line contains the exact moments when the subtitle appears on the screen and disappears from it. The third line contains the actual text of the subtitle. If you want subtitles to look differently, you can use the formatting menu in the Properties window. For instance, you can adapt the size of subtitles to the width of the video, change text color, font, alignment, and other parameters. You can even add a text background and change its color. Now let's talk about the subtitle markup. It's a feature designed to help you work with subtitles with more precision. To activate it, select the subtitles on the timeline and go to the Properties window. Then hit Add Markers. Each marker indicates the beginning of each subtitle. The markup comes in handy when you need to synchronize a video, sound, or effect with narration. If you've noticed that the subtitles in the video have wrong timing or the text is off, you can edit both the text and the timing. Use the top left corner on the timeline to find the exact moment when the subtitles should appear and disappear from the screen. Then adjust the timestamps accordingly. Once finished, hit the Add Markers button again to reflect the latest adjustments. By the way, if you want, you can also change the color of individual markers and create tooltips. Here's how to do that. To work with an individual marker, open the subtitle layer first, then double-click the marker to open its settings. In the Marker Settings window, you can name the marker, add a comment to it, change its color, change its type and visibility throughout the layers. The name and comments can help you make the marker more informative. Different colors come in handy if you need to create control points or if you have more than one narrator in the video. And the marker type just allows you to add the segmentation feature to the marker, so that at the expert level, you can split the file based on that marker's position. Meanwhile, the visibility levels allow you to decide at which level on the timeline each marker will be visible. For example, if you make the marker visible above the timeline on all scopes, you can go back to the main timeline tab and view it there. Otherwise, it will be only visible on the subtitle file level. That's all you need to know to start working with subtitles in VSDC. Let us know if you're already using subtitles, and if so, what you think about the markup feature. Thank you for watching. Until next time.